7,560 hours, 453,600 minutes, and 27,216,000 seconds. him that I'm going to college to major in communication studies. You know what they say, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, or you're supposed to do the things that you fear most in life, right? The important point I'm trying to make here is that throughout our lives, we are going to accumulate different pieces of life that eventually make up who we are as a person. These pieces of us, good or bad, can either be insignificant or can result in greater life lessons that transform us. Whether we like to admit it or not, most of the pieces of ourselves are formed throughout our time in high school. Some things that have happened to us during our time here haven't been fair. Like that free day we never got in 8th grade, even though our class won the class color contest during Spirit Week. We'll all be bitter about that forever. We have also formed bonds with each other and established nicknames through these interactions. Some people during my time in high school have called me Holy Moly, Holy for short, due to the signature mole I have near my eye. But mostly everyone, including teachers, have called me by my last name, Echo. It's even gotten to the point when someone says my actual name, it takes me about 5 or 6 seconds to realize they're actually talking to me. These small, insignificant pieces of us, including the things that we fear, are not permanent. They do not define us. And we have the choice of whether or not to keep them as a part of us. There are some things, though, that we have learned throughout our time at MCA that cannot be replaced. They have been deeply rooted to who we are as a person and who we want to be. There are three important life lessons that I've learned throughout high school that I'd like to share with my fellow classmates, and hopefully some of you can relate. Number one, popularity is just a social construct. It's what you make it. Popularity is feeling good in your own skin, being aware that you're special, and that something sets you apart from the rest of the 7 billion other people in the world. Why try to fit in when you were born to stand out? Number two, the best of friends can be found in the most unexpected places. I've always found that when you're doing what you love the most in the world and being 100% yourself, it's contagious. And the people that recognize this radiance and are happy for you are the ones you want to hold on to. Number three, love your problems. Too often we avoid what's getting us down because of the negativity it brings into our lives. But as soon as we realize we have to love our problems as much as we love the good things in our lives, that's when we're powerful enough to overcome anything in our way. So maybe you didn't get the girl, or win that game, or get first place in the competition. Maybe you're not the hero of this story after all. But there are so many other stories out there that are waiting for you to write yourself into. And the moment that you realize your life is no longer a sad story is the moment that you have a story worth telling. This is just the first page.
Good afternoon. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the ladies and gentlemen joining me this evening on the podium. On my right, School Board Treasurer, Mr. James Britt. School Board Members, Mrs. Donna James, Mr. Anthony Mazzatesta, Mr. Joseph Zanella. School Board Members. Members of the administration, Senior High Principal and Curriculum Coordinator, Mrs. Lisa Marano. Junior High Principal, Mr. Pete Cheddar. Special Education Coordinator, Dr. Monica McCurrence-O'Donnell. Elementary Dean of Students and Athletic Director, Mr. Gregory Sikavage. Business Office Manager, Mrs. Karina Lesko. And the Class Advisors for the Class of 2017, Mrs. Tammy Michaels. Mrs. Handel. And finally, I'd like to introduce the key to our graduates' success. Please join me in recognizing the faculty of Mount Carmel Area School District. On behalf of Mount Carmel School District, Mount Carmel Area School District and Administration, Board of Directors, faculty, and staff, I would like to welcome all of you to the graduation commencement exercises for the class of 2017. Seated in front of me are 112 excellent young people as was demonstrated Tuesday night at Class 9. And as you are about to see, these graduates surely have achieved much at MCA academically, athletically, musically, artistically, and now they are ready to begin the next chapter of their lives. To the parents and family members of the class of 2017, my congratulations to all of you. You indeed have much to be proud of. Your support and guidance has paid off. Isn't this an excellent class? To every member of the class of 2017, we have watched many of you grow through your elementary years, through all of your activities at the junior senior high school, including some memorable sporting achievements, school musicals, art shows, concerts, and even just daily in class. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know that we, the faculty and staff of Mount Carmel area, have the greatest jobs in the world. We have the honor and privilege of watching our students grow, from young children to young adults. And unless you're an educator, you have no idea what a thrill it is to be able to play such an important role in their lives. Members of the class of 2017, I want you to know that we are very proud of each and every one of you. Remember, anything is possible. There are 37 honor students in this class. Some of the ladies and gentlemen on this stage were honor students in high school, and some were not. But our parents and our teachers pushed us as we have been pushing you. And today is your reward. Today is proof that if you keep working and don't give up, you can accomplish much. Class of 2017, you know how special you are to all of us. And we wish you all the very best in college, the military, trade school, or your chosen career. When you sing the alma mater later this afternoon, cherish the moment. And remember, no matter where your path leads you, you're always welcome back here at your home, MCA. Our guest speaker this afternoon has accomplished a great deal since walking across this stage some 19 years ago, and we are honored to have him here with us today. 10 years ago, his father honored us in the class of 2007 with some great words as our guest speaker. Dr. Jed Gonzalo graduated from the University of Scranton in 2002 with degrees in biology and philosophy and received the Frank O'Hara Gold Medal Award, which is awarded to the student with the highest GPA in the College of Arts and Sciences. Dr. Gonzalo received his MD degree from Penn State College of Medicine in 2006. Where he was inducted into the AOA Honor Society and chosen by his classmates as the classmate you would most want as your physician. He then completed his internal medicine residency and chief residency at the Beth Israel Deaconess Hospital in Boston, where he was an instructor at the Harvard Medical School, and awarded the Lowell McGee Award, which is given to a graduating resident who most demonstrates the fundamental importance of teaching to the spirit and substance of being a physician. Following residency, Dr. Gonzalo completed a fellowship at the University of Pittsburgh in general internal medicine and medical education, earning a Master of Science in Medical Education and clinical research in conjunction with his fellowship. In 2012, he was recruited back to the Penn State College of Medicine as a clinician, investigator, educator. Jed's work focuses on two areas critical to Penn State's health mission. Number one, exploring the relationship between education and practice and systems of care. And number two, leading the emerging field of health system science education. As associate dean, he has led the design and implementation of 10 programs related to health systems education, which has garnered national recognition, including coverage in the Washington Post, the Wall Street Journal, U.S. News & World Report, NPR Radio, and AMA Newswire. Jed has a well-established track record for publications with 39 peer-reviewed manuscripts, 34 as either primary or senior author, and 14 as multi-institutional collaborations. He is lead author and co-editor of a textbook entitled Health Systems Science. He is funded externally on several grants, including $1 million AMA grant, $3 million HRSA grant, and Penn State's CTSI grant. Finally, Penn State Tobacco Settlement Fund investigating rural versus urban differences in prevalence and predictors of high-risk opioid prescribing. In his 5 years as a Penn State faculty member, Jed has received 8 scholarship awards, including 2 national awards, Scholarship and Education Award, and the Herbert Mickens Faculty Fellowship. Twice received the HCA-HPS Dean's List for Extraordinary Patient Satisfaction, scoring in the 99th percentile. He's an active research mentor working with over 20 students, residents, and faculty at Penn State and other institutions per year. Dr. Gonzalo is a 1998 graduate of Mount Carmel Area High School, where he was the salutatorian of his class. He was also captain of the 1998 PIAA State Track Championship team and earned a silver medal at the state meet as a member of the 4x400-meter relay. Gonzalo makes his home in Homestown with his wife Tiffany, his son Sam, who is 2, and his daughter Eleanor Rose, 9 months. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our guest speaker this afternoon, Dr. Jed Gonzalo.
Just told Bernie that might be longer than my speech. So thank you to the school board, Mr. Stellar, Mr. Moreno, and Mr. Cheddar, our administrators, our educators, families and friends, and the graduating class of 2017. It is a great privilege for me to be sharing this day with you. I come from a family of proud Mount Carmel graduates. All my family members are Mount Carmel graduates, and I'm proud to say that. My dad spoke to the graduating class in 2007, and being invited to speak in his footsteps 10 years later is a special honor for me. Graduation day is a great time to reflect on where you've been, and also to look forward to the future. And I wanted to know a little bit more about your class, because I don't know you that well. So I asked your teachers. I said, tell me something that you're proud. What makes you proud about this class? And here are some of the highlights of what they told me. They told me that this class has raised greater than $30,000 with the Think Big Dance-A-Thon. There are 24 outstanding graduating band members, and as Mr. Stellar put it, these students will be very hard to replace. Mr. Domansky is over there somewhere. He said the operetta rivaled the Broadway production, and tickets were more difficult to get than Hamilton. Our sports teams qualify for districts in all of boys' sports and 2 girls' sports, and we have a number of individual winners. Our graduates will be attending 22 different colleges and universities across 30 different majors, and 4 are entering the armed forces, which is remarkable. And a few words to characterize this class. This is what they said: dedicated, artistic, great friends. Mr. Joey Rhino said, this class has left its mark as being diverse and unique. Mr. Cheddar, as we would have expected, said, this class is full of pride, and I heard all about your hashtag, MCA Pride. And certainly everyone in this room and the Mount Carmel community is proud of you. So please join me in congratulating this class of 2017. Today you are Mount Carmel alumni, and on behalf of the 16,000 members of this club dating back to 1887, I welcome you. Now that you're members, I'd like to share 3 thoughts with you about what it means to be Mount Carmel alumni. And these are some thoughts that I would have liked to have told myself as I sat in your seats today. My first thought is that I want you to remember your history. Your past is prologue to all challenges you will face. As author David McCullough says, knowing the past is a wonderful way to enlarge the experience of being alive. We can learn a lot from the history of Mount Carmel. We were founded by individuals who sought the American dream. From these generations until today, our history has spawned a profile of who we are as a community and a school. When I was reflecting upon this profile, I had memories of what it was like for me growing up in Mount Carmel. I remember growing up in a household where I don't remember my parents ever taking off a day of work. And the same was true for my teachers and my neighbors. I remember standing in the back hallway of Hope High School in one of the science classrooms. We were looking out the back window with my track teammates, and there was at least a half a foot of snow on the ground, snow coming down all day, and we were happy because we knew there was no track practice that day. We knew that practice had to be canceled, just had to be. Only to find out our track coach had left school early. He was down the track, scooping off the inner two lanes of that track, and we had the longest practice of the year. And I remember quite some time ago, my dad and I were driving down the Dooleyville Hill. It's a third of a mile from where we sit right now. Many of you probably came down this hill today. We're driving down this hill, and there was this guy running sprints up this hill. I said, you know, I'm thinking to myself, this is a steep hill. We go into town, we're in town, 45 minutes, 60 minutes, come back, we're going back up the hill, and this guy is still running sprints. I said, Dad, this guy must be nuts. Who is this and what is he doing? And he said, that's Mike Dimmick. He's getting ready for the football season. I said, Dad, football season is several months away. My dad said, that's what it takes to be good. And that might be one reason why Mike Dimmick is an All-American. To me, these stories reflect our profile, which is one of principles, an unparalleled work ethic, community, and resiliency, the mental toughness to overcome challenges. So what does this mean for you as you graduate today? Your road ahead will not be a smooth one. And often your struggles will come in the guise of seemingly small and everyday things. It's not the big event, but rather the small ones that accumulate and shift your course. When I left Mount Carmel, I did not think I had an advantage. I felt behind and insecure about my humble beginnings. And it didn't help that when during my first college class, the instructor asked, how many students in this class have AP credits? And one girl raised her hand, 71. I still remember the numbers. And a guy across the room said, I have 65. I had never heard of an AP credit. The next question out of his mouth was, how many salutatorians and valedictorians in this room? And nearly everyone raises their hand. 2 months later, my midterm report card comes in. It's full of C minuses and D pluses. It was the culmination of a series of small struggles, and mentally, I had thrown in the towel. Literally every dream I ever had of a career had crossed right off my list. And I made the most important call that I could. I called my dad, and I said, Dad, I'm not built for this. I can't do it. Still remember what he said. He said, Jed, you've been here before and you know how to do this. You take it 1 hour at a time, 1 day at a time, and one exam at a time. And that's what I did. I hung up the phone and I translated every single word of the next day's assignment, and I wore the Portuguese 101 dictionary all the way down to its bind. And for the first time in my life, I got a tutor. I got help and I was not embarrassed about it. What this lesson has taught me is, and which has held true for the next 19 years, is that talent is overrated. You will often think that everyone has God-given talents and abilities, and that's why they are where they are, and sometimes that's true. But what my journey has taught me is that talent is inseparable from hard work and resiliency. Some of you may also think that you come from humble beginnings. But when times get tough, don't think for one moment that you cannot succeed. Thousands of Mount Carmel alumni have walked across this very stage, out these doors, and they have come from the same humble beginnings as you and I, and they have changed the world. You can do the same. Here's my second thought for you. Becoming a Mount Carmel alumnus means you are called to be men and women for others. Our Mount Carmel tradition has never been about individuals or personal accolades. In Mount Carmel, the idea of neighbor, teammate, and colleague means something. And no doubt you will be looking for inspiration as you leave these doors and you go on your journey. We all do. I certainly have my favorite movies of the Rise from the Ashes victory or the triumphant underdog. These stories are what keep us going. In 1932, my grandfather left his family in Portugal with a couple bucks in his pocket. He weathered several trips across the Atlantic Ocean because he could not get into the United States, and he settled here. He didn't choose Mount Carmel because it was going to be a relaxing life. In fact, he lived a very difficult life. Long hours in the mines, piecing together jobs to sustain the family, and dying of black lung. But he made this choice because this was where the work was, and he had a passion for giving his children and grandchildren a better life than his. I stand at this podium on his shoulder sharing thoughts with you about my journey, which compared to his is a cakewalk. And his story is not unlike those of your families who sit here today, our teachers, and generations of Mount Carmel people who have sacrificed in the service of others. And if you were ever looking for inspiration in your life on your journey, you don't need to look any further. To me, this is the most inspirational notion that I have ever considered in my entire life. And I have come to believe that Mount Carmel's best legacy, our absolute best legacy, is that we are built upon the doctrine that we are men and women for others. So what does this mean for you? On an everyday basis, you will be in situations where you'll have a choice to be the type of teammate you would want on your team or not, to invest your energy in helping someone else or not. During these decisions, don't make the mistake of believing that once you arrive at a destination, becoming a nurse, a mechanic, a doctor, making money, that you will find happiness. Our journey will be a success if we improve the lives of others, and perhaps now more than ever, our world needs you. Our world needs change agents, individuals who are willing to step up and demonstrate values of solidarity, justice, and humility. As Mount Carmel alumni, we give more than we take. We are team players, and we are men and women for others. And it is now your challenge to carry on this legacy as you leave today. And here's my final thought with you. This is a personal one, and it relates to one of my favorite quotes. The quote goes something like this: "Not where I grieve, but where I love, I live." This quote reminds us that we don't choose a life, we live it. And we need to surround ourselves by those we love. And certainly you may hear it often, time is precious and it flies by. And if you're following the Facebook, Twitter feeds and everything on the prom, all your parents are saying, boy, it feels like yesterday, they were going into kindergarten, they were going into freshman, the first band recital. And you know what? It feels like yesterday that I walked across this stage with 120 of my classmates and friends. Four of them are no longer with us today. And they were all really great people. We never know when it will be too late. So what does this mean for you? You need to make what you love a priority. And for today, this means that I give each one of you permission, and not only our graduates, this applies to everybody, everybody on stage, our educators, everybody in the audience, everywhere. And I know it may feel awkward or not something you normally do. When the ceremony is over, find your family, find your friends, look them in the eye, give them a hug, give them a kiss, and tell them that you love them. And mean it. Cut your families a break. They have invested their lives in you, perhaps more than you may realize, and they are proud of you. And here's a little insight. You may not know yet what it means to be proud of somebody else. My son Sam is here, he's three. A couple months ago, for the first time, he pooped on a potty. First time. It's the most joyous moment that my wife and I have ever shared together. We were so proud. Graduating from high school is slightly more momentous than pooping on the potty. So please remember that as you see your family and friends, they will always be your foundation. And I will get the ball rolling for you and thank my family, my mom, my dad, my brother, my sister, my nieces, Callie and Ava, my nephew, Zach, my son, Sam, hi, Zach. My son Sam, my daughter Eleanor, my wife Tiffany, I love you with all of my heart, and I am forever grateful to have you as my family. So in closing, thank you for the opportunity to welcome you into the Mount Carmel Alumni Club. As you continue on your journey, I encourage you to remember your history through the hard and the good times. Remember that as Mount Carmel alumni, you are called to be men and women for others, and remember that where you love, you will live. Not only are these important for your journey, but the world needs you to be ambassadors of these values. Thank you. Good luck.
our salutatory of the class of 2017.
Ranked number 34, Kelsey Wing.
Ranked number 33, Haley Leader. Ranked number 32, Amanda Rimakaitis. Ranked number 31, Hannah Gordon. Ranked number 30, Lauren Zandy. Ranked number 29, Lindsay Grassley. Ranked number 28, Julia Ballard. Ranked number 27, Haley Weiger. Ranked number 26, Lauren Startzall. Ranked number 25, Lane Tanning. Ranked number 24, Jordan Reed. Ranked number 23, Nicole Cooper. Ranked number 22, Kevin Stankiewicz. Ranked number 21, Sydney Spears. Ranked number 20, Christina Clayman. Ranked number 19, Selena Guerrero. Ranked number 18, Amanda Ariana. Ranked number 17, Aurora Frouts. Ranked number 16, Madeline Witkowski. Ranked number 15, Madeline Lyash. Ranked number 14, Aaliyah Alderson. Ranked number 13, Austin Reed. Ranked number 12, Casey Rampala. Ranked number 11, Paige Langford. Now, ladies and gentlemen, ranked in the top 10 of the senior class, ranked number 10, Marissa Clayman. Ranked number 9, Sarah Nicola. Ranked number 8, Sarah Parker. Ranked number 7, Aaron Smith. Ranked number 6, Olivia Levinsky. Ranked in the top 5 of the senior class, ranked number 5, Haley Pallett. Ranked number 4, Rachel Brown. Ranked number 3, Alyssa Mako. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm proud to introduce ranked number 2 and escorted by her parents, Justine and Jim Fimoncini, I present to you the salutatorian of the class of 2017, Mara Marie Fimoncini.
James Darrow.
elected to the valedictorian sponsored by the UNB May, Carl Darrow. Carlos J. Manillo, CPA, Tax and Accounting Practices, presents a $100 award to the graduate with the second highest average, Mara Fiancini. In memory of Gerald A. Beierschmidt, his family presents a $500 award to the graduate who places third in the graduating class, Alyssa Lenko. Nutrition Inc. presents a $100 award to the graduate who places fourth in the graduating class, Rachel Brown. Mount Carmel Area PTA presents a $100 award to the graduate who has achieved the highest score on the college boards, Aaliyah Alderson. The Lions Club John Kirsten Award. The Mount Carmel Lions Club presents a $150 award to the graduate with the best record in social studies, Carl Darrow. In memory of Randy Ziggy Zagarski, his family presents a $500 award to a dedicated, motivated, multi-sport athlete who exemplifies the qualities of Randy Zagarski and is enrolled in an institution of higher learning, Kevin Stankavich. The Pomona Sportsman Association presents three $200 awards to the graduates who meet the requirements of their organization. This year's recipients, Justin Parker, Sarah Parker, and Amanda Rimakaitis. The estate of Marie Walsh, former elementary teacher, awards scholarships to students who meet the guidelines of the trust. This year's recipients, Lindsay Rasley, Selena Guerrero, and Lauren Zanning. The Mount Carmel Rotary Club presents a $100 award to the graduate with the highest average in a vocational course, Anna Zeiger. The Antonio Miscavige Family Foundation Award is a $200 award presented to a VOTEC student who has demonstrated the most improved academic performance for all enrolled in the school and who is enrolled in an institution of higher learning to further their trade or technical education. Cassie Vellner. Post number 2110, Veterans of Foreign Wars, presents two $100 awards to a male and female senior who have made the best contributions in school and community leadership, Aaliyah Alderson and Trevor Shooter. VFW Post 2110 of Mount Carmel presents a $100 award to a student enlisted in a branch of the U.S. Armed Forces. Connor Stepp, United States Air Force. Their class and will exemplify characteristics of citizenship and community service. This year's recipients, Brianna Krischke, Christina Klayman, and Marissa Klayman. In memory of Joanne Smith Trepsker, her friend Lorraine Dudera presents a $150 award to a student furthering his or her education. Rachel Brown. A local business leader presents a $200 award to a senior who has shown outstanding achievement as a future business leader, Lauren Starkel. The Hebrew Ladies Aid of Tiferet Israel Business Committee presents a $100 award to the student who ranks 18th in the graduating class. The number 18 in Hebrew signifies life. Amanda Ariano. In memory of Eleanor Finella Matalevich, her family presents an award of $500 to the graduate who enrolls in a school of nursing and fulfills the requirements of the Eleanor Matalevich Trust Fund, Julia Ballard. In memory of Louis P. DiNunzio, former mayor of Marion Heights and longtime resident, his family awards $400 to the graduate with the highest average in chemistry and $400 to the graduate with the highest average in math. This year's recipient of both is Mara Fimontini. Celebration of Special Athletes awards a $350 scholarship to a graduating student that will pursue a career in special education or a related field, Sarah Parker. The class of 1948 awards a $500 prize in memory of Miss Marie McCarthy and Miss Mary McDevitt, former teachers, to the graduate with the highest combined average in English and biology, Carl Derrick. The Two Cheese Royal Cafe presents a $100 award to a graduate who has made outstanding contributions to instrumental music, Emily Stassen. In memory of Francis and Catherine Dea, their family presents a $200 award to a student in the top third of their class continuing his or her education in the medical fields, Paige Meinford. In memory of Robert B. Mulo and Elizabeth A. Mulo, their family presents a $200 award to a senior who meets the requirements of the Robert B. Mulo Trust Fund, Trevor Shooter. Edward Greco Esquire, solicitor of the Mount Carmel Area School District, awards a $100 award to the graduate who is enrolled in a business law class, Lane Tanney. Mount Carmel Area retired
Teachers Association presents a $400 award to a graduating student who plans a career in education, demonstrates academic achievement, and has displayed personal traits desirable in a teacher. Sarah Parker. Now, Carmel Area Township High School Alumni Association presents $500 to a band member residing in the township who is furthering their education. Alora Pope. The Marion Heights Fire Company presents a $250 award to the highest ranking graduate from Marion Heights, Aaron Smith. In memory of Nicholas Udale, former Mount Carmel area band member, his family presents $250 to a deserving Mount Carmel area senior band member, Casey Propalo. Behavioral Specialist Inc. presents one outstanding achievement award of $125 for a student pursuing a degree in social work, psychology, or criminal justice, Madeline Wikoski. In honor of Joseph Jazz Dimonick, former coach and teacher, the Mount Carmel Lions Club presents a $150 award to the varsity football player who meets the guidelines of the trust, Thomas Pastuca. In memory of Ryan Mesmore, two $250 awards are presented to graduates continuing their education in music, art, computer science, or engineering, Madeline Lyash and Olivia Levinsky. In memory of Aaron W. Ziegler, his family presents a $420 award to a football player who will further his education and who exhibits the valor, strength, determination, and competitive spirit of Aaron Ziegler, Wesley Chura. In memory of Catherine Chicatano, her family presents a $125 award to the graduate with the highest average in Latin. There was a tie this year, and this year's recipients are Mara Fimoncini and Kaylee Callow. In memory of Ronnie Chicatano, a $500 award is presented to an MCA student who is choosing to use their creativity and skills to enhance the lives of others, Kiana Adams. In memory of Fuki Chicatano, two $1,000 awards are presented to two deserving students who are enrolled in Susquehanna University, Marissa Clayman and Christina Clayman. Memorial Award presents an award to a deserving member of the music department, Alyssa Banko. In memory of Randy Zagarski, Arcos Industries presents a $200 award to a deserving student who is enrolled in a technical school, Stephen Sundin. In memory of Richard F. Fireschmidt, his family presents a $1,000 award to the highest ranking graduating student who is enrolled at Bloomsburg University, Rachel Brown. In memory of Frank and Marcella Pawlitzki, Dave's Auto Body presents a $100 award to a student who will further his or her education in a technical institute, Tucker Fagley. Presents a $1,000 award to a senior enrolled in an institution of higher learning who loves Mount Carmel area, exhibits spirit, and is involved in extracurricular activities, Amanda Ariano. In memory of Ruth Star- Hartzell Ashman, an award of $200 is presented to a senior who, in the opinion of the faculty, has displayed perseverance and diligence to the best of his or her ability, regardless of class rank and achievement. Lane Tanning. In memory of Lisa Kovas Wachaleski, the class of 1981 and friends present two $100 awards to the students who exemplify Lisa's attributes, which include athletics, school and community service, enthusiasm, lovable sense of humor, and a zest for life. Marissa Clayman and Wesley Sherrod. The MP Scholarship Program awards three $1,000 scholarships to graduating seniors enrolled in a four-year college or two-year trade and technical school and meet the criteria of the scholarship program. This year's recipients, Sarah Nicola, Alyssa Manko, and Julia Ballard. Mark D. Angelo Memorial Scholarship Fund, awarded to a varsity wrestler who has lettered for a minimum of 2 years and demonstrates qualities of good character and integrity. Lane Tanning. In memory of Ray Babutsky, the Mount Carmel Area Rescue Squad presents a $100 award to the vocational student with the highest average, Anna Zeigert. In memory of Ruth Monkevich Kubaki, her husband presents a scholarship to a student pursuing a degree in nursing, Sydney Spears. The Mount Carmel Area Education Foundation presents three $250 scholarships, one in each of the following areas. Academics, Carl Darrow. Athletics, Olivia Levinsky. And the arts, Thomas Sheehan. In memory of Joe Blaze, his family awards a $300 scholarship to a graduating senior who demonstrates the same love and dedication to music and the MCA band that Joe demonstrated throughout his life. Aaliyah Alderson. Specialty Company College Education Trust Fund awards scholarships to deserving students who meet the guidelines of the trust. Nicole Cooper, Hannah Horning, Haley Leader, Jordan Reed, Alexa Erickson, and Kelsey Wayne. In memory of Ann L. Annie Sebastian Alexander and Blaze Robert B. R. Alexander, their friends and family present two scholarships to graduating seniors who will pursue education in a business or technical program and who best exemplify their values and traits. Lane Tanner. In loving memory of Nathan McFadden, a $500 award will be presented to a senior with a great love for life and family, one who faces every challenge with courage, strength, and faith, the lessons that Nathan taught us throughout his life's journey. Kyle McFadden. Robert Dave Irishman presents an award of $100 to a senior band member that exhibits leadership in the band, Aurora Krauss. The Robert Sowell Memorial Scholarship presents a $350 award to the highest ranking member of the senior band, Carl Darrow. In memory of Denise Niglio, Frank and Cassandra Niglio present one $100 award to the student who most exemplifies the traits of Denise, Madeline Wikowski. Lucia Spichulski. Her friend Lorraine Dottera presents a $150 award to the student furthering his or her education. Erin Smith. The Albert and Rosalie Ross Memorial Scholarship awards $500 to a student who will be attending Penn State and meets the guidelines of the trust. Olivia Levinsky. In memory of Leonard Eschmar, a 1937 graduate of Mount Carmel Township High School, a $100 scholarship is awarded to a deserving member of the football team, Wesley Sherrock. In memory of William J. Shannon, Nora Clayton and her family present a $250 award to a graduating member of the baseball team who most exemplifies the love of the game of baseball, is quiet and self-confident, competitive and self-driven, Austin Reed. Presents two $1,000 scholarships to students who have served as a firefighter of the Clover Hose Company, is in good academic standing, and will pursue higher education. Trevor Shooter and Caitlin Trent. In memory of Anthony Scopaz Jr., a 1981 graduate of Mount Carmel area, his family presents an award of $2,000 to a worthy graduate for the purpose of furthering his or her education in music. This year's recipient, Noah Adams. The Mount Carmel Area Jets and the Tri-County Region Football Organization awards $200 to a member of the Mount Carmel Area High School football team who has participated on all levels of the Jets program and who has displayed citizenship and sportsmanship on and off the field. Trevor Shooter. The class of 1953 Joint Senior High School Scholarship presents a $100 award to the 53rd student who is furthering his or her education. Thomas Mastuco. Costello Jr., his family presents a $1,000 award to a senior football player who best exemplifies the leadership traits and dedication of Joey on and off the field. This year, his family selected Zach Zarkowski, a graduate of Florida State. Fred G. Smith Golden Rule Scholarship Trade School Award has awarded two $5,000 scholarships. This year's recipients are Kelsey Wayne and Steven Sundman. Before I recognize the members of the class of 2017 who are going into the armed forces, on behalf of the school board and administration, I'd like to take one moment to thank the numerous alumni and friends of Mount Carmel area who have so generously supported our graduating students. This year, they have awarded over $47,000 worth of scholarship money. Thank you. At this time, we would like to take a moment to recognize the members of the class of 2017 graduating class who are entering a branch of the United States military. It gives me great pride to introduce the following graduates. When I read your name, please rise and remain standing at your seats. Joseph Bierster. Selena Guerrero, Army. Connor Stepp, Air Force. And Michael White, Army.
we would like to recognize the following scholarship recipients in the class of 2017. Students are asked to please stand when your name is called. The PMEA District 8 Award in the amount of $300 to Kutztown University, Noah Adams. The Joseph Quad Scholarship in the amount of $2,000 to Bloomsburg University, Lane Tanning. The Penn State Scholar Award and Ms. Gavin Scholarship in the amount of $3,500 to Penn State School Board, Hannah Horning. The University Scholar Award in the amount of $12,000 to Temple University, Aurora Kraft. The John J. Yastak Scholarship in the amount of $16,000 to Bloomsburg University, Rachel Brown. Merit Scholarship in the amount of $24,000 to Harrisburg University of Science and Technology, Donald Bailey. The Merit Scholarship in the amount of $32,000 to Misericordia University, Johnny Bosner. Wilkes University Provo Scholarship in the amount of $52,000 to Wilkes University, Amanda Limikaitis. The Merit Scholarship, Andy McCauley Award, in the amount of $72,000 to Misericordia University, Julia Ballard. St. Andre Bassett Award and the King's Grant in the amount of $72,000 to King's College, Nicole Hoover. The Blessed Bazille Moore Award and the King's Grant and the Excellence Award in the amount of $80,800 to King's College, Carl Darrow. Scholarship in the amount of $104,000 to Susquehanna University, Bryce Malick. The Presidential Scholarship in the amount of $112,000 to Susquehanna University, Christina Clayman. The Presidential Scholarship in the amount of $112,000 to Susquehanna University, Marissa Clayman. Trustee Scholarship in the Susquehanna University grant in the amount of $134,000 to Susquehanna University, Sarah Nicola. The Merit Athletic Scholarship in the amount of $252,000 to Bucknell University, Mara Fiamanzini.
in sharing our strengths and gifts and talents with the Mount Carmel area all throughout high school. We have so many athletes, musicians, TV studio members, artists, news reporters, FBLA participants, and various club members who excel in their respective activities. All of these things allow the very special and talented members of our class to share our gifts and represent our school all over the area. As we branch further away from Mount Carmel, we're going to take with us the talents we've learned and the gifts we've acquired so we can share our strengths with even more people. So now the thank yous to those who have shared their strengths with us and who helped us discover our own strengths. I want to thank my family, my aunts, my uncles, and my cousins for the support they give me. Thank you to my four grandparents for coming to everything and always being there. And of course, for all the good food. A huge thank you to my sister Lisa for being the best role model that any little brother could ask for and for being my number one fan in absolutely everything. Of course, thank you to my parents, especially my mom, who not only does so much for me at home, but also helps me at school as an amazing guidance counselor and one of the best class advisors any class president could ask for. Between my mom and Ms. Michaels, our class grew very fond of our advisors, and we as a class are going to miss you guys very much, and we thank you. I also have to thank all the people sitting to my left here, and all the great folks who work in our school. Whether or not I personally have you as a teacher, I want to thank you, all of you, for helping us grow from little tiny elementary students to awkward, strange middle schoolers, to the young men and women we are today. Your patience is to be praised, and your teachings will not be forgotten. I also want to thank my fellow classmates. Thank you for the friendships and so many memories we've shared. Thank you also for sharing your talents you've acquired with me, with each other, and with our community, and for just being awesome. And lastly, I want to thank our Heavenly Father for the countless blessings He has bestowed upon me, my family, and our class. So that's my speech.
Rose Minko. Kiana M. Mattis. Noah Liam Adams. Aaliyah Brianne Halderson. Brooke Lynn Andrews-Gabbard. Amanda Ariano. Her diploma is given by Donna James. Julia Nicole Ballard. Nicole Marie Belts. Joseph A. Beerster. William Eric Beerster. Johnny Joseph Bosler. Rachel Marie Brown. Benjamin Hawee Boy. Elena Catherine Cauldron. Dylan Michael Carey. Aaron E. Kastner. Mariah Kastner. Deshaun Tylee Janner. Thomas Allen Sheehan. Alyssa Conlin. Brandon Christopher Dauber. Bryce Thomas Dauber. Brian Michael Dietz. Jessica Lynn Eckley. Alexa Carol Erickson. Tyra Erickson. Haley Ann Espinoza. Tucker Wade Fagley. Sarah Elizabeth Freeman. Aurora Marie Krause. Timothy Michael Fulotsky. Sierra Zoe Grady. Casey Darren Krahowski. Sarah Krebs. Selena Faye Guerrero. Nicole Mary Hooper. Megan Elizabeth Horvath. Cole Jordan. Ariana Frias Huber. Marissa Lynn Kaczynski. Christina Mary Clayman. Marissa Marie Clayman. Alora Dannon Coke. Brianna Ann Christie. Paige Victoria Langford. Shane Francis Larkin. Haley Paige Leader. Olivia Nicole Levinsky. Madeline Eve Lyash. Taylor Mary Catherine Maschieski. Brianna Raquel Madison. Bryce A. Malek. Joseph Mailer. Blake T. Marlowe. Jessica Martzall. Adam M. Maskell. Corey Scott Matter. Stephanie Marie Matakaitis. Corey Shaylin McCabe. Stephen L. McCullough. Kyle James McFadden. Kobe J. Nichol. Zachary Michael Miller. Nicholas Miscavige. Sarah and Nicola, presented by Tony Mazzatesta. Haley Rhiannon Pallet. Damian Michael Parker. Justin J. Parker. Sarah Catherine Parker. Thomas Matthew Pastuca, presented by Donna Hughes. Lawrence Eric Paff, Jr. Stephanie Elizabeth Price. Jordan Alexia Radzevich, given by Donna James. Lindsay Marie Brasley. Draven Michael Reddick. Woo! Austin David Reed. Jordan Robert Reed. Amanda Emily Rimakitis. Nelson Rivera Jr. Casey G. Rapallo.
special place in it for special people. There are very special people here tonight, and we, the class of 2017, would like to recognize them at this time. Will the parents and grandparents of the class of 2017 rise at this time to be recognized by the graduating class?
Your grandparents.
Thank you.
Thank you.